not who you were expecting, Rhea. I'm here because I have a very important message from the WWE Women's Champion, Nia Jax. Stay out of her business or else you're gonna have a problem. A big problem.
Tiffany, I understand that you think this is Tiffy time and whatnot, but it's not, because I don't got time for this. Either I get my hands on Liv or Raquel, or I can welcome you back to Monday Night Raw the Rhea Ripley way.
Oh, they've got company. Raquel Rodriguez and Liv Morgan.
Raquel Rodriguez looking more powerful and dominant than ever. And Rhea Bloody Ripley is now beating the hell out of the champ, Liv Morgan.
Raquel just slams down Tiffany Stratton.
Well, if you need somebody to deal with Rhea Ripley, who better than the massive Raquel Rodriguez?
Oh, my! And Liv Morgan with the Money in the Bank briefcase right over the back and then throws it down on Tiffany Stratton.
Just as Cargill looked to be fading, it seems Kairi Sane simply is too quick for Cargill thus far.
This time she catches the crossbody.
Huge backbreaker. Kairi Sane getting the stuffing knocked out of her. It's hard to move that fast when you simply can't breathe.
Powerbomb delivered from Jade Cargill. And the cover. And coming in was Io Sky. Championship on the line.
Championship opportunity was slipping away for Damage Control until Io Sky's intervention, but it might be academic at this point. The champ's in full control and looking to put this one away. Kairi Sane getting out of dodge just in the nick of time. That is backfired for the champs.
And look at Jade's reaction once she realizes that the target wasn't there.
Well, Jade was completely blinded by the fact that she was picking up Belair. Had no idea that Kairi Sane had moved.
Genius of the Sky missile dropkick springboards it and then kicks up. And now all of a sudden, Damage Control finds momentum.
With Jade Cargill nowhere to be seen.
Right on top with that elbow. Hooks the leg to take the titles. Kick out. And the over the moonsault comes up empty.
Well, thankfully for Belair, it was Jade Cargill pulling her out of trouble. And now the powerhouse Cargill taking out Kairi Sane with a little help from her friend.
I mean, Jade and Bianca. And now look at this, Lash and Chikara. They just lost to them on Friday night and are still barking and jawing. Io springboard moonsault to the floor. And Io Sky. And now she gets the attention of Lash and Chikara, saying, hey, this isn't your moment. Just sit down and watch. Oh!
A cheap shot to the jaw of Io Sky. I don't think Bianca Belair saw that that had happened.
Io Sky damaged ringside. And now Bianca Belair.
Referee didn't see it either.
The vertical suplex after she just ate that. And could it be KOD? Bianca to retain, yes!
Here are your winners, and still the WWE Women's Tag Team Champions, Jade Cargill and Bianca Belair!
And I'm sure somebody will call me a politician for doing so, but there's nothing political about what I'm going to do next. It's quite simple. Thank you all very, 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 very much. With that in mind, so St. Louis, Missouri! What do you want to talk about?
You just love to be everybody's darling, don't you? See, the thing is, because of that, you're in that mess with your old friend Kevin. Because he realizes everybody's friend is no one's real friend. So I expect you to sort out your emotional mess, because in Saudi Arabia, I expect the best version of Cody Rhodes.
If I could make an observation, one champion to another. I've seen what happens when the ring general throws everything in his arsenal at his opponents and they keep coming back. What happens is you get uncomfortable. What happens is I have seen it firsthand. I saw it at WrestleMania. You break. You think you are swimming in the deep waters, but your feet are still touching the bottom of the pool. You have never been in the ring one-on-one with me.
That's a very fair assessment, Cody. Spoken like a true secondary champion.
There it is, that dig. I was expecting that, and I should have been. This is indeed your house now. Gosh, you really have become frightening. You've become a frightening beast. And what you call me, a secondary champion? Let us not forget, I defeated the most dominating champion in company history.
Well, this might be good night.
Able to get out of the way was Kofi.
It was a mad scramble. It was about the only thing that could possibly keep Kofi Kingston in this match. And Breaker, in the process, may have badly injured that shoulder.
Yeah, that right shoulder went right into the post. Of course, he comes with such speed and velocity.
May well be his own worst enemy. Done himself some real damage, and it's up to Kingston, the veteran, to try and capitalize on that while he can.
Can he do that? As Braun Breaker tries to take control for a moment. Kofi, springboard crossbody, right into the cover.
And that is the kind of movement that Kofi needs, despite the beatdown he's taken so far in this matchup. It confuses Breaker, keeps Breaker guessing. Breaker only has one speed.
Boom drop, Kofi Kingston.
Deviate from that, you get in problems.
Looking for trouble in paradise. Instead, finding Braun Breaker.
Tossing the body of Kofi Kingston around, but those cat-like reflexes of Kingston.
One, two.
And a kick out by Breaker.
But Kofi really has done it all. He stopped the test of time. Can he stand the test of Braun Breaker, who keeps bouncing back?
Shut up! Saw the long-time success with the New Day, but as you noted, conspicuous by his absence is Xavier Woods.
Kofi Kingston clearly hurting all over, but going skyward.
Yeah, finding his way to the top rope. Double axe handle, but no, the badass, belly to belly, and look at how far he tossed him.
Technique, power, explosive nature, and a mean streak a mile wide.
Super spear opportunity, Braun Breaker delivers.
Just cutting Kofi Kingston in two.
And with that, the win.
Here is your winner, Braun Breaker!
Last time we saw him landing the super spears, it was following the Intercontinental Championship match between Jey Uso and Xavier Woods.
This is not...
And Xavier Woods comes in. So that's when he shows up, when Kofi Kingston found himself in trouble after the match.
Well, that's a true friend in my book, putting himself
absolutely
on the line, getting in between Breaker as he was looking to destroy a beaten Kofi Kingston.
Xavier Woods does the right thing. Oh, and then he comes and attacks him from behind.
Attempted clothesline, look more like a jawbreaker type move, and Woods is in big trouble. Wait up.
There's company, and it's the current Intercontinental Champion.
Well, it's the man who was jumped by Braun Breaker on Raw last week. Now time for a little revenge.
Super kick.
Here I go.
And a spear of his own. Jey Uso sending a message back to Braun Breaker.
Taste of your own medicine, but let's face it, Joe, these two may well be on a collision course, a rematch at some point for that Intercontinental Championship. But man, did Kofi Kingston need his friends this evening.
A statement, Yeet, as Breaker knocked from the apron. New Day and Jey Uso out to defend each other.
Got a second? Please, just hear me out real
quick. I said no.
And get out my face, man.
Rhea on the outside with Raquel. And look at Tiffany, the discord between these two. A team that was just thrown together, arguing over who's legal and who gets in for the action.
Well, suddenly,
Tiffany Stratton is a stickler for the rules for the first
time. Oh, meanwhile, human missile Liv Morgan from Raquel. And a drop kick that sends Raquel flying.
And finally, a little taste of vengeance for Rhea Ripley. Fighting wars on two fronts here. It might be a little too much. Who am I kidding? Nothing is too much for the Eradicator.
That knee hit hard. She wants the Riptide.
It's exactly what she gets.
Stacks her. And Raquel comes in to save it. Rhea Ripley, oh! Nia Jax from out of nowhere. Nia Jax comes running down as Tiffany Stratton was up top looking for the prettiest moonsault ever. Meanwhile, Rhea Ripley was looking for a Riptide. The next thing you know, Nia Jax comes from out of nowhere.
Well, Nia Jax, who certainly is not supposed to be here. Look at the wreck shop, and look at this from Ripley.
And Liv Morgan takes out her leg. And just beating down now on Rhea Ripley.
Just when Ripley was about to pull off the unthinkable. Wait a second.
Now Nia Jax turns her attention on Liv Morgan.
The woman she will be facing at Crown Jewel.
November 2nd, these two women will go after it in the first annual Crown Jewel Championship.
Oh, God. It's squashing time.
Annihilator. And now if you are Miss Money in the Bank, what a golden opportunity.
It's happening.
Could this be a cash-in?
at the first opportunity here on Raw.
With the briefcase in hand.
Wait a second. Look what
the Dirty Dom comes in the saber.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Just in the nick of time.
Born to be the greatest of all time. This is where I draw the line. Can't stop my shine. They know it's my time. Let the world know I've arrived. I'm on the rise. Unstoppable.